Hi guys, welcome to the Rebel Engineer YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be talking about why LeetCode in 2024 is useless and what you can do to land a job in this very difficult tech market. So just a couple of days ago, we have some new layoff news. Bay Area tech giant PayPal is laying off people around 9% of its workforce. And also Block, another fintech company, is also laying off about 1,000 people or around 8-9% of its workforce. So Jack Dorsey, the CEO of Block, said that they would keep their headcount to around 12,000 people this year. That means that most companies from now on will try to run on as little headcount as possible to achieve as maximum of their profit as possible. So they are trying to run very lean. Even UPS, the delivery company, is gonna slash 12,000 jobs to save costs and force their workers to come back to the office. Now, if even UPS is slashing jobs, it means trouble for the economy going forward, and it will also mean more layoffs coming in 2024 and possibly 2025. So let's come back to our tech industry. So as you know, most companies in 2023 and 2024 only hire senior plus software engineers role. That means that, you know, engineers that graduated from our college or engineers that are only entry level or have 1 maybe 2 years of experience are having a really hard time to find jobs right now. The reason why they only hire senior engineers is because they want as little training as possible for engineers, so higher expectation and almost lower pay across the board. As you have probably noticed, most companies in 2023 and 2024 only recruit senior and above roles. That's because senior plus engineers are gonna be likely to ramp up faster, and they will also require less training. Training, onboarding, and mentoring engineers are the biggest costs that companies have to pay for new hire engineers. All of these are happening because the economy is sagging, AI is on the rise, and also, you know, companies want to maximize their shareholders' value. So essentially, if you are an entry-level engineer or mid-level engineer, you are the last in and first out engineers. That means that you are the last one to get hired and you are the first one to get let go. If you don't move up, you have to move out. That's the fact of the matter in this economy. Even if there are companies that are recruiting entry-level and mid-level engineers, they do so with expectation that these engineers will move up the ladders as soon as they can, and they will have to spend as little money as possible on these engineers. So let's come back to LeetCode. So the point of solving LeetCode historically has been to get into FAANG companies or some, you know, mid-sized companies. Most of the LeetCode questions that people try to aim for are hard or, you know, medium-level questions. But the trend I've seen recently, especially when I participated in interviews at different companies, is companies are starting to asking less and less rigorous LeetCode questions and more so on the system design, and they pay more attention to the behavioral part. You have to understand that system design and behavioral interviews are the two pillars of the senior engineers. So even when they interview entry-level or mid-level engineers, they try to aim to see if these engineers can actually move up the ladders to become a senior within 6 months or 1 year or 2 years. So that's why nowadays they ask easier LeetCode questions, especially at startups and even at some of the FAANG companies I have interviewed in the past year. And also they are focusing more on the system design. If you are an entry-level engineer in this market, you probably already knew how hard it is to get your foot into the door. Chances are your resume will likely be tossed into the trash can as soon as the HR person receives it, because most people are looking for 2 to 4 years of experience for an entry-level role nowadays. So if your resume won't even make it to the table of the hiring manager, then what is the point of solving so many LeetCode problems, especially medium to hard problems? Because that's not what the companies are looking for nowadays. If you look on YouTube, you can see that, you know, there are many videos saying, hey, they solve, you know, hundreds and thousands of LeetCode questions. And I see these videos everywhere, every day. But the problem is, like, nobody cares. No companies care about these in 2024. because companies are leveling you for senior and above roles in the future. So they are interviewing you with the expectation that you will move up the ladders as soon as possible. Even if you work at FAANG companies, even the senior engineers don't use these data structures and algorithms and these complex LeetCode hard questions every single day. So the idea of solving these every day, especially even if you are aiming for FAANG in this market, you have to understand that as soon as you get into FAANG companies, maybe in a couple months or a year, they will do another mass layoffs. So FAANG is no longer a staple of a stable job. So if you are an entry-level or mid-level engineer, companies look at you as code monkeys. Essentially, we have AI and copilot nowadays, so companies will need less and less of these code monkey levels, and they will need more and more of the people who can actually design system, who can actually communicate across teams, and who can use prompt engineering to maximize their productivity. Entry-level engineers and interns alike are treated as burden and cost and expenses, and they are not viewed as revenues. And if you just take a brief look into the job market, you go to most of the FAANG companies' website, you will see that there are less and less opening for engineers at entry level. And we probably have less entry level engineering opening than any time in the last couple of years. Okay, enough talk about all the layoffs that are going on with the mid-level and entry-level engineers and all the disadvantages that you guys have. Let's talk about what you can do as an entry-level and mid-level engineers to go through this market in 2024. So my first tip for entry-level and mid-level engineers who are trying to find jobs in this difficult market is to prioritize applying to roles that are hybrid or on-site. So this would go against the advices of many other people and probably would annoy some of you, because we all know that people nowadays, most people prefer to work online remotely, or they want to work in a hybrid setting. But I would say that the more entry level you are, the more you should aim for more on-site time. The main reason for this is a pool of candidates that you will have to compete with will be smaller, because you only compete with candidates locally and don't have to compete with candidates from United States or the entire of North America. So that will make your job of finding and competing with other candidates much easier. And so you think about it, right? What is the most important thing for you right now? If it's not finding a job or getting a job, then what is, right? So if your priority right now is to get a job as soon as possible, then you know you should take all the advantages that you can to win the job that you want. So in this case, you should really aim to do things that others don't want to do, and that includes coming back to the office. Unfortunately, we are living in a very difficult time, so that may be something that you have to put up with for the next couple of years. If you are the type of person who wants to stay at home and work remotely, or if you are the type of person who only wants to go to hybrid offices, and I'm very sorry, but the fact of the matter is the market is very difficult, and you know any advantages that you have, others also have, especially if you're an entry-level engineer. So you got to narrow down and lessen the competition if you really want to get a job as soon as possible. So this return to office push, whether it's hybrid or on-site, will actually be good for you if you can actually put up with this RTO period at the current moment until the market gets better and the workers get more rights and demands. You can actually, after that, transfer to companies that actually work hybrid, or when you get more experience, you can actually transfer to another company that have, you know, hybrid or even remote work models. But when you are more junior, you should definitely aim to go further than others if you really want to win in the job market. So that is my first tip. So even though companies are actively laying off right now, they're still recruiting for roles that are relevant, and they actually force people to return to office as, you know, another way to do layoffs and maximize shareholders' profit. So that's, you know, essentially if you are entry-level or mid-level engineers, please aim and consider to aim for hybrid and on-site roles. The number two tips I would like to give to you is please consider smaller companies and smaller startups. I believe that the last numbers I looked at into the layoffs at FYI, the most recent numbers, mostly the layoffs come from big companies, like big well-known companies. If you aim for smaller companies, which actually don't require, you know, medium to hard LeetCode questions for most of them, and they still, you know, of course require system design and everything, but if you aim for, let's say, a less well-known company, you are more likely to succeed than you aim for a big company. And even if you get into a big company at the moment, it's very likely that you will be laid off later, because I believe that the wave of layoff will not stop this year. we will have layoffs every year, as I said in a previous video. So, you know, layoff will be an annual event from 2023 onwards. And, you know, the companies that do layoff the most will be the big companies. The companies are inefficient. The companies that have lots of fat to trim. And those are usually the big tech companies. If you aim for smaller size company, it is more likely that first you will have the ability to climb up the ladders and grow up in their ranks. And the second thing is, when they are smaller, they are already very lean. So most of these tech startups, they already did lots of layoffs in 2022 when the Russia and Ukraine war first broke out. So right now they are running pretty lean, I would say, from my own interviewing experience. And I would say also from all the numbers online I see from layoffs at FYI. So, you know, getting into the smaller companies, you know, even though it will hurt your ego a little bit because we all lead code just to get into FAANG and big tech, right? We want that, you know, brand, nice brand on a resume. But what you need to aim for right now is not just nice brands, but you need to aim for experience, years of experience, scope, etc. So when I worked at big tech, when I was working at Google, I knew many engineers who came from very small companies, from very smaller startups. In fact, my tech lead at the time, the senior engineer in my team at the time, was actually from a startup in San Francisco, like a no-name startup that nobody ever heard of. So even if you get into a smaller and medium-sized company, it won't sacrifice your ability to move into a big company later when the job market gets better. So essentially, that's my take on this. And please note that during the interviews for these smaller startups and big companies alike, they will look for signals that you can actually get promoted to senior roles as soon as possible. And we will talk more about the signals and the behaviors of a senior engineer. But for now, just say that, you know, you should focus more on system design and should focus more on behavioral rather than just coding LeetCode away. The only thing you know is LeetCode. Then even if you apply to FAANG, you will get like maximum to mid-level. But I know like even at Facebook, Meta, they still ask system design for mid-level. That's according to my latest data. So I would say that, you know, you should practice system design and behavioral interview way more. You should prepare 3 to 4 projects that are very interesting, that you can dive really deep into the technicals. And you can also talk about all the aspects of leadership, all the aspects of mentorship that you have done, all the aspects of, you know, interviews that you have done, etc. In order to practice system design interview, I would strongly recommend a book from Alex Su called System Design Interview. And he has 2 volumes, volume 1 and volume 2. And I would strongly recommend if you are going to interview, even if you are an entry-level or mid-level engineer, you should be looking through these books and work through the examples and write them on the whiteboard so you understand system design better. For behavioral interviews, just make sure to prepare 3 to 4 interesting projects that you are willing to dive deep into. And also don't forget the conflict resolution, the strength and weakness, the typical behavioral interview questions. And they may ask these questions in related to your other projects. And we'll do a deep dive into all these in the later videos. And the third advice I would like to give to mid-level and entry-level engineers who are trying to find jobs in this difficult market is to focus on industries that are not tech industries. So for example, from my own research, I've seen that healthcare, defense, space, AR, VR, hardware, I would say, hardware in general, and the AI chip manufacturing sector, and they are really needing people. So they're recruiting like crazy right now. You should be able to get interviews or land entry-level or mid-level engineering jobs in these companies because they are on a hiring spree. So these companies are actively hiring, unlike tech companies that are currently laying off. These companies are the companies that actually are wanting to have more fat, more layers, more, you know, engineers to execute on their visions because they work in very rapidly growing market segments. So yeah, focus on these niche industries and don't just focus on the brand names, don't just focus on the prestige, etc. All of those are outdated concepts from, you know, a couple years ago. But I believe that the tech job markets will be different from now on. It won't be the same. It will never come back to the same place because all companies nowadays will invest very heavily into AI, VR, AR, all these, you know, hardware intensive and cost intensive initiatives. So there will be less and less money and budget for the software engineers. You should really look into companies that have their software lagging behind the software of other traditional tech companies. And working for these companies that have their software outdated may be a great experience for you, because you have a chance to work on software for niche markets that are growing and growing every day. So yeah, I would say that make sure that you don't focus too much on LeetCode. Don't worry about the LeetCode hard questions. Focus on the easy and medium questions, and make sure that you aim for lower tier companies. Aim for companies that go hybrid or on-site instead of the remote ones. And also aim for niche industries, niche markets where their software still needs lots of work. So that would pretty much sum up this video of mine. Please let me know down in the comments below, what do you think about LeetCode in 2024? Do you think it's outdated? Do you think that we should aim more for the hard questions instead of the easy or medium ones? Please let me know down in the comment below. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.